Hi, educators. I hope you're doing well. My name is Edgar Chen, Partner Marketing Manager at Microsoft Education. Thank you for taking time and checking out this session, Amazing Learning Apps in Microsoft Teams. In this session, you'll hear six of our partners, GoOne, Kahoot, Mento, Prezi Video, Quizlet, and Wakelet demo how their solutions integrated with Microsoft Teams can help you achieve better learning outcomes for your students and also enhance their personalized learning, especially during this challenge time. So what are we waiting for? Let our partners show how their solutions can help you.
This is an overview of the free GoOne Teams app for educators to be able to deliver learning content to students from within Microsoft Teams. Here I'm in Mrs. Smith's math class in the Learning Materials channel, and I'm able to lay out sections on this learning tab that correspond with the units of my class, but really it's flexible to organize learning content however I want. I can add the title for a section here, and I can also describe this section of learning content. Once I've done that, I'm able to add individual resources of learning content, like web links, files, and interactive files, like a SCORM file, for example. Once that's been laid out, as a student, I'm able to access learning content easily, whether that's a web link, a file, a more complex learning resource, like a SCORM file, or educational publisher content. I'm also able to easily have a discussion about a particular learning resource. And that discussion is a standard Teams conversation thread, so that if I go back to the primary conversation tab, I'll see the comment I just made, and the whole class sees that this learning resource is being discussed. If someone's interested in it, they can easily click on it from the main conversation tab, in this example for a YouTube video, and access that learning content seamlessly without needing to log into any other systems.
Hi, I'm Melissa. I'm a PM here at Kahoot, and in partnership with Microsoft, we built an integration that'll enable you to play with your class directly on their platform. Here's Patrick, one of our teacher ambassadors, with how he uses our product with Microsoft Teams and with his class today.
I'm going to show you how to use Microsoft Teams and Kahoot together to supercharge online learning. Setting up Kahoot into your Microsoft Teams couldn't be easier. Simply add it as a new tab, search for Kahoot, and sign on with the same Microsoft credentials that you've signed up for Teams. No need to create a new account. When you're fully installed, all your games that you've created in Kahoot will be ready for you to be able to play live with your students on a Meet Now or to assign them to the students asynchronously so that they can learn at their own pace. Assigning a challenge game into your team allows your students to be able to learn and play at a time that suits them. And your students see a reminder as to how long they've got left to play the game. Kahoot and Teams is the teacher's dream. It's so easy for the students to get on and to play live. Simply start the game and the students will pin in the code to be able to join you to play. Here's a game I played with my students when on remote learning. And I used some of the questions just to check in on them, to see how they were doing and see how they were feeling about what they're learning. It's a good way to get a big picture of how everybody's progressing. The leaderboard adds a lot of fun and adds that dimension of challenge. And you can mix up the questions. Short, low-stake questions are a great way of building up the confidence of students online. But it's also really nice to use the slides feature to introduce new knowledge, short, bite-sized chunks of new information, and allow the students then to be able to apply that immediately into a learning context and check for understanding. Kahoot really does push that active participation in learning. And of course, everybody loves it when it's their turn to feature on the podium. And it's a great way of encouraging active participation and challenge. I hope you get the same amount of fun out of using Kahoot in your Microsoft Teams with your students as I have with mine.
Ati Taisarig, PhD, adjunct professor at IDC Herzliya. And I use Mento as a way to engage my students in collaborative, thoughtful discussions. I started using Mento as a way to engage my students, to have them interact with each other, and most importantly, to enable for them to express their voices, their opinions, their thoughts on the topics that we study. Mento for me is a smart discussion board in the sense that it uses analytics to empower the students and enable them to improve, as well as suggesting assessment components for me to use in a more objective manner that I could have done prior to using Mento. So I use Mento also because my students love it. They seem to think it's very similar to social media, so they feel very comfortable with it. And it effectively builds their skills, their way of making a good argument. Mento is fully integrated with Microsoft Teams, and students can view the discussion, answer the discussion through Microsoft Teams. They can also open their own, open the little iframe to see the entire discussion, as well as answers given, contributions, replies to the discussion, as well as additional elements such as team analytics and my analytics. They can also turn to the web version of Mento from within Microsoft Teams, where they can view the different discussions. And from within the discussion, of course, they can see, in this case, the recap, but also team analytics, my analytics, and I can view the assessment for my students. So super helpful in how it engages my students in discussions, and I wholeheartedly recommend it. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Katerina Moore, and I am an English language arts teacher at the Roper School in Michigan. What I love about Prezi Video is how engaging the graphics are and how easy it is to create new and exciting content for my students. I've been using Prezi for years, and with Prezi Video, I am able to easily create new content for my students in Microsoft Teams. All I have to do is choose a template, put in my course content, and hit record. And I'm able to then record for my students any reminders that they may need for the class or maybe a mini lecture. And once I'm done recording, I'm able to save the video and post it right to my students, again, without having to ever leave the Microsoft Teams app. I can also do a lot more with the Prezi Video desktop app. For example, I can import a PowerPoint that I've already created in the past, and it will reformat it into a Prezi Video form. So then I have slides that I've already created in the past right there next to me, and I don't have to do anything new. If I want to, I can add new content. I can go live in a video conference, or I can record a video for a later date. My students love Prezi videos because it gives them something different to look at every day. Right now, it can feel monotonous being online all the time, but being able to create something quick and easy and fun to look at is so important to me and my students. If you want more education on this, go to www.prezi.com/education for more information on how to integrate Prezi Video into Microsoft Teams and your educational environment.
Hi, my name is Rory Yakubov, and I'm a high school math teacher in Old Bridge, New Jersey at Old Bridge High School. I've been using Quizlet for the past 4 years, and I've also been using Microsoft Teams for the past 4 years. And having Quizlet directly integrated into Teams has made my teaching experience, especially with remote learning and hybrid learning coming up, much, much easier. So I just want to show you that in all of my teams here, if I click on my algebra honors period 910, you can see directly at the top, I have all of my integrated apps directly in here. And when my students log into Teams, they see everything that you see here on my screen. They also then can just easily click on the Quizlet tab that I've set up at the top. I put it in as not an app, but actually the website link directly to my page. So students with one click in Teams are able to access my entire Quizlet account. They can access any of the 140 Quizlet study sets that I've actually created here. They can scroll through really easily, and again, directly within Teams. That's what's so easy about it. They don't have to open up any extra separate browser. They can also directly log in with their Quizlet account. On the first day of school, I had all my students set up Quizlet accounts, join my classes, which you can see I have a period, my Algebra Honors period 9-10 class set up. And then students are easily able to access all of my study sets by either just typing into filter. So let's say today we did lesson 5.3. They can simply type into 5.3. They can easily access the study set for the lesson we just did, or even access the quiz review that I have for that lesson and other lessons included. Using Quizlet in my class has been incredibly easy, especially through Teams. Whether students are doing independent practice, I'm having them study at home, or we're running Quizlet live sessions. If you have any other questions about how to use Quizlet or how you can easily integrate Quizlet into Teams, definitely go ahead and give Quizlet a follow on their social media channels, or just go to Quizlet.com, and there's so many tutorial videos that are also linked to their YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.
Hi, I'm Jenny Long.
And I'm Celie Clark.
And we are Jenny.
We are so excited today to share with you our three top tips in using Wakelet with Teams. So our first tip for you in using Wakelet in Teams is the top tab integration.
So the first thing you're going to want to do is go ahead and open the Wakelet that you want to share to your team in the top tab. Go up to the very top and copy the long link in the address bar. Now go back to Teams, and we're going to click on the plus button. Go ahead and click on Wakelet, and if you don't see Wakelet, you can always search for it here. Paste the link and click Save.
Voila, there it is.
Love it.
Our second tip for you is to actually add Wakelet to a post. This allows you to take any collection that you have and add it into a post so that your students can have conversation around that Wakelet.
You can also add a collaboration link as well to your post, and this allows students to go into the Wakelet and leave comments and collaborate right there within the Wakelet. All right, let's show you how. So here we are on the Wakelet we want to share. You can copy the share link, or you can even copy the link in the browser. Click copy. Now head back to Teams. The first thing you're going to want to do is click on Apps in the Me space on the left-hand side. Then search for the Wakelet app. You're going to want to click the app and install or activate it.
Here we are in our team, and we're going to start a new conversation. So I'm going to go ahead and put some text in here, and this is going to be related to the Wakelet that I'm going to share to this post. Then I click on the W down at the bottom, and then I can search all of my collection.
Search for your topic, choose your collection, and it will automatically add to your post.
And if you're a Wakelet Spaces fan, our third tip is for you. You can add any of your spaces as a top tab within your team.
Go ahead and head to your space and click on the profile of your space, grab that top link, and then go back to your team. And we're going to simply add it as a top tab.
Here's an important note. Make sure you add it as a website, not a Wakelet. Just paste that link right here and click Save.
Voila, look at that space. We hope you enjoyed these tips from Jenny.
Bye.
Hi, welcome back. It's me, Aquarius again. I hope you had a good time learning these new solutions. Visit the website of GoOne, Kahoot, Mento, Prezi Video, Quizlet, and Wakelet to learn more about their solutions. And check out our latest Microsoft Education third-party solution brochures via aka.ms/edu-apps. You will find hundreds of solutions under different categories, such as accessibility, communication, and student engagement. Download the brochure and explore these solutions to save you more time, improve your students' learning outcome, and enhance their personalized learning. Thank you. I hope you have a good day, a great ST 2020, and a happy early holiday. Bye-bye.